I've been lost in this town, even though I know my way around. Didn't take me long until I found the devil. With just one word, I knew his voice. It's the one I heard at every choice I made. Just trying to be a rebel in a small town.
Oh, yeah.
In a small town.
Hey, baby.
If you jumped off of our front porch, you'd land right where the Civil War was fought.
What the hell you doing, man?
It's never been forgotten.
Oh, my God.
20 miles to the interstate. There's a Burger King and a Motel 8. And the only thing between here and there is cotton. Jeffrey prays to Jesus. Asking him, please just help us through one more day. Jenny gets high, waste her life. But me, I just ran away from a small town. From a small town. Sometimes it was heaven, sometimes hell. Kinda like church, kinda like jail. There's a water tower, says welcome to nowhere. As soon as I could, I was long gone. My jeans were torn and my hair was long. Now I can't believe I wanna go back.
Hey, mind,
hi, Dan. How you
How's
doing?
It feel to be retired?
Hey, Doc.
Well, it feels great.
You out of here? You need a ride or what?
I'm heading that way.
Okay, I am.
Has
too.
It sunk
I'm
in yet?
Huh?
Has
there.
It sunk in okay. yet?
No, not yet. Wait till Monday morning when the alarm doesn't go off and I jump out of bed.
There you go.
Oh, shit, I'm late.
That's what it is.
It is.
I'm going to go.
But I knew
I'd come back someday.
Yeah, yeah.
Mondo Ramos, round of applause.
To a small town.
Life.
To a small
such as Mondo.
Yeah. Don't tell him.
The make life better. He's a good-natured soul. He's my first football coach. He was the man.
That's right.
Yeah. That's right.
He made me and Brandon and other kids ran our asses up the hill over and over again after practice. Thanks a lot for that. But I tell you what, like I said earlier, there's certain people out there that you meet in life that make life a pleasure. You're one of those people, Mondo. For the man, the myth, the legend, like it says on the board, Mondo the man, you are the man.
Thank you, man.
We thank you for being a good friend, a mentor, all of the above, and I want to thank you for letting me and Brandon drink beer in your garage when we were 16.
Well, if it wasn't for Mondo, I wouldn't be married to Mandy. And then I wouldn't have two
hair.
Beautiful little children.
And yes, they are.
Are you? Yes, they are. Good job, Mandy.
Yeah!
Hey, go, Mandy.
You did something right.
Whenever I try to get mad at Mandy, I always realize I better not do anything I might regret because you got a big ass brother, big ass father. It's been a pleasure. It's been about, God, 10 years now since
yeah.
I've known this
yeah.
Yeah.
I don't know, but it was Mandy.
Mandy's on the early one now. No.
She's right here with the camera.
Hey, that's the one you've been talking to.
Oh, that is.
Hey, Danny, tell him what he asked you when you asked if you could marry her. What he told you?
What I tell you?
I go, Mr. Ramos, can I marry your daughter? And he goes, are you sure about this?
I did.
10 years later, I'm still very, very sure about this. And I'm just really, I came up here, he got me, I used to be scared to sell nuclear stuff, you know, and I'm like, I'm never going to go up to Richmond, that place is crazy. No, it's the safest industry in the world, safest industry in the world. And so, lo and behold, I came up here because I like bass fishing, and I thought, well, I better get a job, too, to support my habit. So I'm working out there in the area, and it is the safest, and I don't know, just most professional, and the people up here are great, and, you know, I just, what can I say, man? I'm looking forward to many years of having you around as my handyman.
To my brother, congratulations for retiring. It's a beautiful thing for you. But, me and my brother, I mean, I love my brother dearly. Me and him never had a relationship until about 8 years ago, where me and him became close. Now, we got a 10-year difference between us. But the thing is, I always loved my brother. I respected him, and I always admired him for what he did.
How come you didn't shave your hair,
though? I lost my hair.
What hair?
You didn't have me that well.
I don't
know him that much. No. But,
you're the youngest or the
oldest? I'm the youngest of the six.
He's the baby.
I'm the baby of the family. I am the baby. I got my brother who's the oldest. I got four sisters between us. They used to dress me up in petty skirts.
Tell us more.
I don't want to even imagine that right now. But yet, my brother, I always admired him.
Show him your underwear.
My brother did a lot of things. I know my parents are very, very proud of my brother.
Yeah.
Because they wish they were here today, my parents. Their health stopped them from coming here. But they expressed to me that they really appreciate and love Armando because he is the firstborn.
He's a mama's boy.
My brother, I love you very much. Congratulations for the last 30 years of your hard work and what you did in the nuclear system.
Zai, we love your Mondo. Dude.
Yeah.
Hey.
Here's the hot chick mobile.
This is the hot chick mobile.
We got five women here that are only
involved. Okay. So you're not ever
seen this. I'm just going to keep the tape running now that Bobby's drunk.
Now that Bobby's drunk.
Get all the.
All the decks. This was just a straight box when they moved in.
Really?
But it's like there's only 30 more units in the whole town. All these L houses. All this, put all the decks on, everything.
Nice.
Wow. Yeah. Oh, I like your beamer. Mama's new spot.
He calls it my car.
Oh, I know.
John,
you traded the bubble?
And the babies are like, where's your car, Grandma? I miss your car, Mama. Shut up.
Oh, my goodness. Is that cool? That's good.
Who wants white wine?
I love it. Oh, I've got wine in the back of the car.
So it's white wine.
You want white wine, you want red wine, you want
red.
Hard liquor.
I want a double white, red vodka.
Mandy's got a white.
Oh, man, we got the hard liquor.
Okay.
Oh, okay, God. I got a beer in there. And no, what do you want?
Doesn't she have
I like that.
Pretty, ain't she?
Oh, what's his Gimme was going to take her home.
Well, somebody was telling me, who's that one girl in the dress?